that something?
Yeah. How long did this take? Because I see some sap, dried up sap.
Oh, well. I don't know. Not sure.
It looks like from the sap, it looks like he's drooling.
It was years of training, I can tell you that. This isn't the only tree that you're going to see like this in here. He probably didn't want to destroy the tree, so he'd have to move on to another tree before he did too much damage. But I would imagine he would do this the way he trained in probably an 8-hour period, you know? Because this is really not much damage for what he could do. You see, these were actually made not with sticks, you know. These carvings were made with machetes. And over again, he would sit there and hack with machetes. Much like this. Until an eye was carved and a mouth was carved out of the machetes. Machete is a long-bladed weapon, but it's used for like hacking down woods and brush. But these weren't ordinary machetes. These were Filipino machetes called compilongs. Now the compilong wasn't an ordinary machete. It was a Filipino machete, and when you master the art of the Filipino machete, the compilong, it makes you a very powerful and a very dangerous person. Now this training and the years of dedication that David put forth in this training method, these training methods, made him a mass guru. I've seen David Tanner knock down oak trees in a matter of hours with his machetes, with his compilongs. Now let me show you something, son. You see this hole right here?
Yeah.
This was an entryway to an underground room that David Tanner had made. You see? Yeah, well, it's filled in now. But during his training missions, he would make these underground rooms so he could sleep right where he trained. And he'd come in here and he would sleep, and he would probably have some food in there, some drinking water, and that's all he would do, is sleep in there, sleep in the woods, and train, and train, and keep on training. That's how David Tanner became a mass guru. Now look here, son. Watch your step. See, now here, the signs of the room that he had built. Now he would line the walls with 2x4s, and then he would line the 2x4s with plastic to keep it dry. See, as evidence right here. See, this had a solid 1-foot roof when he was staying here. And they tried to come and bulldoze it down, but they obviously couldn't. So what they did was they just buried over the top of it. That roof's probably still down there. If you dug your way in, you could probably still sleep in that room. Seek shelter there. Who knows? David Tanner might actually secretly be coming back here.
But how can he tell him to go?
Oh, you don't know the methods of David Tanner. There might be an entrance to this room 50 feet over there now. If he has his mind on doing something, nobody's going to stop him. Not a bulldozer, an old man for sure. Believe me, if he wants to sleep in there, he will. See, look at me, look there. There's one of his old training dummies. See, with the carpet wrapped around the wood?
Yeah.
That is a classic, low budget, but very sufficient training dummy that he would use out of just materials he would find around anywhere. And there's more rope there, you know. Look. Yep. There's the rope. There's the base. There's the dummy. That's what I'm talking about. That might be the entrance right there. To the fort. To the underground room. Well, we better not mess with it too much. Okay, come on, son. You know what this is, you know? See, David Tanner, when he was cooking on turkey, he would cook them in this hibachi.
For Thanksgiving?
Well, just to eat. Just to eat. That's how he lived. He would pick berries, and occasionally when he needed protein or something like that, he would catch the turkeys, and he'd cut them up here in the woods, and he'd cook them on this little hibachi here.
How does he start a fire in a little hibachi?
Well, son, he would probably have rubbed 2 sticks together. is here. It looks like nothing, right? You see the old vinyl on it? It's all deteriorated. Again, this shows you how long this stuff has been here.
This is collectible stuff. This, you know, we could take this back and probably sell this as David Tanner's old training equipment. And I bet you people would pay a high dollar for this.
We could actually sell this on eBay, you know, and maybe buy that new bicycle you've been wanting. Okay?
Okay.
All right.